So I'm gonna play some sounds for you on this piano. And I'd like you to listen really, really carefully. And then repeat the sound with your voice.
Okay.
Should we try? For example, I'll show you, like that. Can you sing a little louder? Good job, how about this? How about some thicker sounds? Like, oh, oh. How about this? Oh. Very nice job. Now, I'm gonna play for you a few sounds and see if you can repeat after me, okay?
Okay.
Listen. Check something. I want you to close your eyes. I'll play the note and then you'll try to find this note on the piano, okay?
Okay.
But don't peek. Find it. No, no. Open your eyes
okay. And
try to find which note I played. Your hands. Good job. Listen carefully. I'm gonna clap for you. You listen and then you'll be a copycat.
Okay.
Okay? Listen. Almost. How about this? Rush to start. Listen, think, and then clap. Like that. That was perfect. That was great. A little harder. Excellent job. Great. Okay. So, in the beginning of this book, we learn about each other with you. So here, you can cut out my picture from here and paste it here, right? And on this frame, or other way around, you'll put your picture. You can paste your picture, real picture, or you can draw yourself here.
Okay.
Do you like drawing?
Yeah.
Yes, very good. So here I'll write my name, so you don't forget. Mrs. Gorin. And on the next line, you'll write your name. Do you know how to write your name?
J, come on.
Good. See?
That's a J.
Yes. Another letter, right? Excellent. your name. Now I will not forget either. All right. But now, before we get to read the story, I'd like you to listen to the music. I actually am going to play it for you. This song for a piece I'm going to play for you about two animals who like to fight. So you listen carefully and you try to guess what these animals are, okay? And you'll try to just, you don't have to close your eyes. Because it's such a big instrument. It's actually not a kid instrument. It's a grown-up instrument. When we practice it, we need to sit correctly at the piano. So let's look at that boy and see how he sits. His feet has stand on the floor, but because you can't reach the floor, they will stand firmly on this little stool. Do you have something at home?
I was just looking at that. We don't, so I'll try to...
Do you have just a step stool?
Mm-hmm.
That will work.
Okay.
I have two.
Two. Perfect. So, we talked a lot today about mice and cats, right? You'll read the story again at home. And we're going to try to play with you a song called Three Blind Mice. Do you know the song Three Blind Mice?
Mm-hmm.
Listen how it sounds. And look, see there are black keys here, right? We'll play with fingers that is in the middle. We'll play on three black keys. Listen. Three blind mice, see how they run. Do you think you could do that? Let's try. First, I'll help you. Relax your hands. You don't need to stick fingers out. Relax, relax. Yes. Three blind mice, relax. See how they run. Can you try by yourself? Three blind mice, see how they run. Wait, you missed one. See how they run. See how they run. Yes, but make sure you don't stick fingers out. Keep them relaxed and rounded. You'll have... Good job. You know, you can actually play a lots of songs on these three black keys. For example, Mary had a little lamb, little lamb, little lamb. Mary had a little lamb, its voice was white and small. Do you know this song? Let's try to play it. But first, I want you to hold this ball and look at your hand. Look. How rounded your fingers are. They're not sticking out like that, right? So when we play piano, our hand is very relaxed and holding. Or if you hold the pencil with your fingertips. With your fingertips. Hold. Hold, 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 hold. Good. See your fingers? They're not stiff or tense, right? They're just lightly holding. The same when we can play the piano lightly. Try to play two little songs, okay?